happens is you get in the industry and you play your stuff for rappers and A&Rs, and you'd be like, oh, okay, you got a Kanye sounding beat. But I know Kanye, so why would I buy a Kanye beat from you when I can just go get one from the real Kanye, you know what I'm saying? The thing that's going to set you apart and that's going to get you in there is having your own sound. Like, nobody else sounds like Jay. So, when he goes in there and he plays his beats for a rapper, you know, he's going to be like, oh, man, I was looking for a beat like that, man. I couldn't get one of them from Kanye. I couldn't get one of them from Just, but you got it. So, from there, now they're copying beats from Jay, you know what I'm saying? And then if the song does well, it's like, okay, I'm going to need that sound again. Going back to Jay. Not the Jake imitator, not the, you know, whatever, so. Ah, looks like Jake has come up with something, huh? No?
Still trying to figure this shit out.
Yeah, at least with the same.
Oh, you had a question?
Like, technically, in during the creative process, is there anything like that's the most challenging part of the creative process for you?
The most challenging part?
Yeah, what's the most challenging part of like your creative or technical process in terms of making the beat?
Finding the inspiration in the first place. Like music out there, man. So I guess filtering out all the whack music and just stuff and being inspired by it.
What's
know?
White music? What do you consider white music?
What do I consider white music?
You know, everybody's definition is different.
Right. Plies. I think Plies is white. There's so much.
You got
more general, start with Plies.
You got a more general description, so is it like cornball, like cheesy sounding, like is it whack beats, is it underproduction,
I like cheesy shit too. I just don't like Plies. I love Rick Ross, I don't like Plies.
Rick Ross got good meat.
You said what?
So Rick Ross got good meat, or I can't take away the fact that he makes good music, but he's a fake ass. I can't co-sign that shit.
Man, hip hop itself is fake.
And if any of them niggas get called out, I'm not going to co-sign that shit.
I mean, that's true enough. That has nothing to do with me liking the record.
But the music's good. So
the music's dope. I like it, man. I came up on Run DMC. Man, they talking about doing all this. And DMC said, if this beef you knock out team, well, damn well, DMC's not going to knock nobody's team out. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not tripping on that, man. As long as it sounds good, you say it with conviction, man. You know what I'm saying? There you have it, man. Me and this guy have arguments about this all the time, man. Because he's like, man, the words sound power and words mean something, and you shouldn't be putting bullshit out there. Man, that's not real hip hop. You know, a lot of people say that. You know, that's a debate that we can have for years.
I think if people is famous over their persona, like Rick Ross famous over their persona. That's that's what made people like him, is his persona, not necessarily the fact that he could rap. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, if people get famous over like rapping skills, like, for example, like Corey Gunz, like people like him because he could rap good. You know what I'm saying? People don't just, I like his swag. People like Rick Ross' swag. Or, you know what I'm saying, they like his persona, the image.
I like his music. I don't know about his swag.
But I mean, like, if he didn't have that persona in the beginning.
I don't want to see Rick Ross, actually. I don't care about his swag. The big dude,
I mean,
the beard,
you
know, I don't want to see that. You know what I mean? So, I don't know. I feel what you're saying, though. I mean, well, like I said, I don't hear too many records pass.
So, where do you find inspiration if you don't find it?
If I can't find them that, I'm digging in the crates, man. I'm gonna throw on some Marvin Gaye, some Donnie Hathaway, some, you know, something with some melodies that entice my ears, basically. You know, it could be anything. I might throw on some SWV. Who knows? You know, it just depends, man. Whatever sounds good at the time, and if it sparks an idea in my head, then I'm gonna keep rolling with it and, you know, do that.
You ever use like Frank Zappa or anything like that?
What's that? What's the group he was from? Mothers of Invention? I like his group that he was in, his rock group, before he went solo, too.
Oh, Holy Rounders. You heard that shit? That's pretty weird.
I sound like, oh yeah. Would I listen to it? No. I will give him whatever he wants, as long as he has the amount of money that I have. Like I said, I won't be bumping. I don't even think I would sit through the studio session if I didn't have to. If he pays me for the mix down, he'll get a mix down. You know what I mean? At that point, if I'm not feeling the music, it becomes all professional. You know what I mean?
Unless he asks you a question.
But you know, when I work with Redman, Redman's my guy, you know what I mean? We had a rapport before that. So, you know, we cut him a break on a couple things, you know what I'm saying? Like, man, get us in the back end and whatnot, man. Because I'm a true fan of Redman, you know? So it's different. But Plies, no. Rick Ross probably, I probably wouldn't listen to that track.
I'm curious, what do you think about Gucci Man?
That's a funny one, man. Yeah, he's actually made some songs that I like, man, but he's garbage.
I was just curious, because I'm listening to Gucci, and everybody listens to Gucci in the hood now, and I thought I missed something, like, maybe he's tight, and I'm just whack now.
I mean, man, see, I'm not, there's certain stuff that I'm not bumping that at the crib either, though, you know what I mean? But if I'm in the club, man, and it's popping, I'm definitely not trying to hear Pharoahe Monch at that point, you know? I need to hear some 808s, get some finger snaps if I'm in the club, you know what I mean? So, it all depends, you know?
What about
if
you're in Europe?
If I'm in Europe? Oh, it's gonna be the Kid Cudi remix. Y'all like Kid Cudi?
Yep.
No Kid Cudi fans?
I like it.
I was subpar.
You said what?
I said it's flows subpar.
Subpar?
But his music's good. You know what I'm saying? Like, he makes good overall music, but as far as rapping.
Watch your boy Drake. Y'all feel that?
I've been liking Drake for some years.
What's your biggest critique of like young emerging producers, and then what would be your word?
My biggest critique of young emerging producers would be a disconnect from the foundation of the culture problem. Like, I don't really want to get into this too tough, you know, because I'm an old bitter man when it comes to this sort of stuff, and like a guy that samples an MP3 and has never seen the actual record, that's kind of clowning to me. To me. But I understand at different times. You know, my kids make beats too, so like, my son is like, man, I'm taking an MP3, man. I don't know nothing about no records. That's what you old guys did, you know? So, I don't know. But my biggest critique would be like, a young guy coming up and not even respecting that part of the culture, right? You know? It took guys 20 years of digging through records to make the hip-hop sound that you hear today, so why would you diss a guy that samples records, you know? That's probably my biggest critique. Other than that, I like mostly what the young cats are coming with, especially these new styles and all the resources you guys have. So you guys can have a sample and have a million keyboard sounds on top of it. And in our day, we only had like 8 sounds we could have in a beat, you know? So I like how it's advanced, you know? I like the new sounds and the new textures that everybody brings. I just don't like the disconnect from the foundation of the culture. And me, the foundation of hip-hop is a record, because it started with a DJ, so that's what it is.
You like to send beats?
I think it's garbage, but my son's beats.
You tell him he's garbage?
Yes, I do.
How old are you?
16.
Oh, okay.
But, nah, the same way my big cousins that was on that Grandmaster Flash, you tell me I was going, man, that's garbage, man. You know what I mean? I see what you're going for, but that's garbage. You know what I mean? And to have that challenge and that, for me, that spark, you know, it's like, oh, I'm garbage, huh? Oh, yeah, I'm coming back hard on you next time. Next beat tape I play, man, I'm about to kill you, oh, God. You know what I mean? So that's why I tell them that sort of thing. I'm not trying to put my confidence down. Right? I'm just like, look, man, you want to sample this, you don't even know where it's coming from, but cool, you know, but I would prefer you know where your sample